feel so good in my hood tonight. I can't sing. We're going to have some fun today. We're talking about Don't Shoot the Messenger. Man, I don't know. I listened to, I guess 102.1 in my area has some really old school music, which old school is like when I was a kid. But today, good morning to you, man. We're talking about some Don't Shoot the Messenger messages today. And this is something that I think we all need to hear. Good morning, Next Level Network Space. Good morning to you. We need to talk about this because I know there's a lot of people in life. There are a lot of people in their lives, man. I don't know who's in your life or who's rocking and rolling with you, but here's the truth about what I have realized in my life that will give you some, hopefully, some amazing benefits to how you you look the next stage of what you're doing, this bad boy we call life. And here's the thing. In the world we live, we got a lot of friends. And our friends, man, they care about us. They want to tell us things about ourselves. We got to learn. They want to give us lessons. And sometimes when we're hearing these lessons, let's be honest, we don't want to hear these lessons. We don't want to hear what they have to say. And when I say lessons, it's not always like a life lesson. Good morning, Liv. Cassandra, good morning. Good morning, Existence. Good morning to you. Good morning, Carrie Ann Puglisi. So we're not talking about like they don't give us life lessons. We're not talking about people coming in and like sitting there and breaking down lessons. But you know there are people in your life that when they come into your life, how you doing, Sidelum, that are actually they're trying to give you insight. And here's what it looks like. Maybe you drink a little bit too much. Your friends say, hey, man, hey, Nick, man, you got to stop drinking so much, bro. Anthony, maybe you should stop drinking so much alcohol, man. You need to stop doing drugs, bro. I don't do drugs, but you know what I'm talking about. And people give you insight. And what happens is this insight comes in, and sometimes, not all the time, we're like, I don't want to hear all that. Like, I'm not a fan of hear. So what we do is we'll cut people off. And this is bad. This is a negative thing. And I'm telling you, it's a difficult thing whenever you cut people off, because here's what ends up taking place in life if you cut people off. I have noticed in my life by watching my own life, that there are some people that love you, that care about you, that love me. Good morning, Ty, Jackson, Maria, that care about our world, that they care about the things we're doing. And what they try to do is give us insight, give us perspective so we don't butcher our lives, so we don't mess things up and we get some better things out of our life. We'll go and here's the thing. It's usually the people you complain to consistently about not loving what's going on. There's somebody in your life right now, you know, you reach out to go, hey, man, this is going on in your life. And they just say, okay, I know. Hey, didn't I tell you should have? Haven't I told you before you got to do this? And you keep, yeah, but I just can't. Whatever it may be. Good morning, Angela. So what happens is we have these people in our life always telling us stuff and we don't take the advice, man. We become assholes. We ask, hey, what would you do in this situation? And they tell us and we go, no, it's not me. I wouldn't do that right there. Well, then why are you asking this person in the first place? Why are you asking for advice if you can't take the advice given to you? And what I mean by this is you have things that can give you great insight, great information, but we don't always bring it in. Moms and dads are great on this. Parents are big on giving us insight. Good morning. Greetings from Venezuela. Hello, hello, Foxy Brown. Hey. And so what I'm going to give you as a thought today is this. Maybe the people you keep close to your life know something about you that you can't quite see. Maybe you don't have that self-awareness just yet, and you're wondering why you're falling short of this next level of success you're trying to get for your life, but you're not taking in the insight. You are killing the messenger. The messenger is someone who cares about you, who loves you, who's trying to give you some insight. They're delivering a message to you saying, hey, maybe you should start reading more books if you say you want to make more money. Maybe you start being nicer to people if you want to get that promotion. Maybe you start showing up to work on time if you want to make sure you get to keep your job, right? Maybe you want to stop eating that trash and you want to get in better shape. You keep asking them. You can keep giving you answers, but you don't take the insight. And it's not always a life-changing one. It may not always be some life-changing crazy. It may not be that one that all of a sudden lights you up. You're like, that's the thing, right? But it might be the one that starts you down that path. It might be the one that triggers something that goes, yeah, I've heard this the last 3-4 years from this person. I finally listened to it. I finally heard it. Good morning, Nolan. I finally heard it and I did something a little bit different from this perspective. And what I'm giving you as a thought today is you need to go seek those out more than you shut those down. Repeat this. You need to go seek these out more than you shut them down. Because in my life, I've noticed this is what takes place. If I have someone in my life, if you have somebody in your life and they give you some insight and what you do is shut it down, guess what never happens again or rarely happens again? Them giving you gold. They fail to give you more insight because why would you keep trying to help the person who doesn't take the help? Why would you keep trying to give the insight to somebody who doesn't want to take the insight? After a while, it's like, man, I'm not even going to give you this. I'm not even going to talk to you about this. Why? I'm going to move on with my day. Hey, go do you. Do what you do when the separation occurs. And you get to watch other people live better lives. And it sucks. I guarantee you know someone right now that maybe used to be your friend that's doing fairly well right now. And if you'd only listen, If you'd only paid attention, if you'd only heard this thing, and what happens is we get to these points in time, we realize like, man, I could have easily been this higher level, been doing something greater if I just heard that message and listened. Well, now I'm telling you to find these people, because if you kill this messenger, if you cut off these people, what ends up happening is you don't get to the point of being able to increase your level of life in ways that could be done if you just took the message and stopped shutting it down because your ego gets in the way. I'm going to be honest, you know, this is the thing. Your ego gets in the way. And it's a problem for a lot of people. The ego becomes EGO, everyone's greatest obstacle. You got that? It could be all of our obstacles. It could be an amazing tool. The ego is an amazing big thing, but I'm telling you, it could also be an amazing obstacle for us because we don't want to take this insight. We don't want to take these things that help. I appreciate you. She says your vibe will attract your tribe. I like this. It's true. So what happens is we got to get to the point of realizing that if we're going to get our lives to be better, man, we got to take these things into our lives and realize they are beneficial for us and do something with them. Regardless of if your pride is hurt, your ego is hurt, it doesn't matter. And here's what it usually looks like. It comes in two forms, people. Two distinct forms, and I want you to grab these two forms, and here's what takes place. Roy Frater says, can you go over the pre-order specials? Was looking at, oh, I like that, Roy. So Roy is looking at my pre-order specials. I'll go over that in a minute, Roy. I got this message I want to share. So here's what takes place in two areas, right? So area one for a lot of people is what they end up doing is they say, well, I see somebody doing well. I see someone at a certain level. Maybe they're giving me some insight, and I see something. And what I do is either option one is this. I feel less than. So what do? I demonize them. Bad people make money. Bad people have that job. Who wants to do that? Look how stupid that is. Who would ever want to do this? I have someone in my life who literally told my son not to take a certain job, that this person is far below like the job that they're talking about. It's incredible, amazing to me, but I'm like, why would they do that? Well, if you feel less than, the only way to feel equal or better is to demonize and lower that thing. If we're being honest in life, we've done this in some capacity, and it's not the best thing to do, man. So what ends up happening is we get to points in life where we're looking at other people's lives going, well, yeah, they suck, and they're stupid. And no, if you deep down think about it, you want that same success. Own it. I want that. I want to get that. Like, because that's option two. Option two is I go and say, I want that. I respect that. They're doing a great job. What do I got to adjust to get there? What can I learn? What info can I take in to be better in my life? It's not about sitting there and saying, I want to feel good right now about where I'm at, protect my ego. It's about, I want to feel good of where I'm at later on and have a big, positive, powerful, joyful ego. I want to feel great about myself. It doesn't happen if you demonize the great things in life, if you don't take the insight, if you don't take the message from somebody. So stop shooting the messenger. Elevate the messenger. Respect the messenger. Pay attention to them. Listen to what they're giving you as insight. Because when you get to that point, when you listen, when you love, when you learn, your life changes. And that's all I'm about, people, making shift happen. I'm telling you, here's what I will tell you. I learned this at a speech years ago. The biggest room in the world is the room for improvement. I repeat this, you can get it. The biggest room in your world is your room for improvement. And when you lean on that, when you understand that, when you take that message in and it makes sense to you, you can go, man, all right, I can improve. So when I see people doing well, I see them up there killing it in the world, I don't try to demonize them. I don't try to diminish what they got. I elevate it. I show it. I make it beautiful and amazing. And I say, I want some of that. I want that joy. I want that peace, man. I want that money. I want that house. I want that notoriety. I want that. And that's okay to want it and experience the feeling now of not having it, because it tells you you can step into that room of improvement for your life. And that's where you get more done, where you have that joy, where you create that space, where you live in a different, joyous, abundant area of your life. I'm telling you, it's right there outside your reach. And so if you can get this message today, which I pray you did, the simple message is this. Don't shoot the messenger. Rise up. The savvy nail chick says, rise up. Yon Diaz says, I love it. I love it too. Oh, Nicole Duncan says, I rocked the boat, learned something. Thank you. See, that's big, Nicole. How you doing, Nicole? It's been a while. But that's the thing I want you to take from this today is do something in your life, maybe today. And this thing, the messenger may not just have to come to you. Maybe you don't wait on the messenger. Maybe you go and find the messenger, ask some questions, get self-awareness, find out what you think somebody else is thinking of you should be done. And when you find that thing out, like maybe it plants a seed that goes, oh, I can go do that. That could be better. And then you can start ruminating on it, right? Let it kind of simmer, let it set, and things can build and grow. In my life, it's happened many times. Believe me, I've had people. Here's an interesting story about the world of what I do in this identity realm. I had this business called Trust Your Hustle. Logos, brands, courses, everything called Trust Your Hustle. And I sat in this meeting with some guys. I will do a mini name share, but I think you need to realize the room that I was in this time. So it was in Jackson Hole, Wyoming. It was in like 2000, maybe like 17-ish. I can't recall what it was. I'd already been in this role of coaching, speaking, talking, sharing my story. And I'm sitting in a room. It's not even a room. It was outside. We got done shooting some shotguns. It's me, Brennan Burchard, Lewis House, Dean Graziosi, Trent Shelton, Jeff Walker, Russell Brunson, like some big dudes, phenomenal hearts, amazing names. I don't mean by big physically, like bigger in the world, right? And we're all sitting around. It's a whole like breakdown. It's a mastermind. And so we're sitting there and there's a breakdown. It's my turn. I share my story. Hi, my name's Anthony Trucks. This company's called Trust or Hustle. Here's my story. Here's what I do. But it broke it all down to me. And when one of the guys says, I mean, granted, I've created this thing for a couple of years. I've been building into this. This is who I am. One of the guys goes, I don't like it. Got him, Ethan Willis. I don't like it. What do you mean you don't like it, Ethan? Like, hold on. This is, you're making me feel bad in front of all these big guys, these big names. These, what do you mean? You don't like it? And he goes, well, yeah, there's more to it. He's like, you know what? This whole thing of Trust or Hustle sounds cool, but he's like, it's gotta be message and messenger. You gotta talk a message that lines up with the messenger who is you. He says, you're the messenger. You talk, you speak, you share, but the message just isn't the one. He's like, I wanna know, how'd you go through all these things you went through? The foster care, the all-white family, the football, losing football, family falling apart, all these things, kids at a young age, meeting your real dad, all these nuances. He's like, how did you get here? How did you go through these different shifts of your identity to make it here? And his message was, you need to change gears. Now, here's what took place. I was presented with a place for my ego to say, I'm gonna stay in my lane. I was talking about, I don't want that. I'm good here. I could have easily protected it. But then I was like, well, what if I open my brain for a second? What if I don't shoot the messenger? What if I listen to what's going on? What if I listen for a moment? And I did, and I let it all come in. I let it simmer, and I realized, man, he's got a point. There really is a uniqueness to my life and identity and what I figured out and how I've accomplished success in my life. Like, man, there's something here. I let it settle in. I didn't shoot the messenger. I took this message in. The ego pulled away, and I got a chance to peek into something great. And I'm telling you this because it could be the same thing for you. Go and seek this out. I could peek into a different future, and I saw something that was more unique and different and more beneficial that actually tied very deeply to the work I'd already been doing in an odd way. Like 70% of it was the same stuff. And it tied to my story in a way that landed so much more powerfully for people. So it allows me to talk more, be more, show more, do more, impact more. And that's what I'm giving you as a gift. It's a simple lesson of you got to find these people that you don't shoot the messenger, take the message in, and let it change your life. Because it can. Something as simple as the way that you show up in the mornings to your marriage. Some as simple as the way you parent your kids when they come home from school. Whatever it is, those little nuances, take those in. Find out where they fit and plug them into your life and make the adjustments. And I promise things will game change for you. It'll be a whole different world. And if you want to know more about this, you got to grab the book or pre-order right now. There was a question on it before. Roy Frazier said, so if you go to identityshiftbook.com, you can actually grab a pre-order of this book. There's some bonuses you can get. There's a masterclass I'm putting on. It's a six-level masterclass through the different ideal identity levels. There's also one where it allows you to actually get one-on-one work with me to do a complete audit of your life, an identity audit, and allow you to figure out how to create a 12-month plan that walks you through how to make your shift and actually upgrade your life through some crazy cool things we do. But if you're not just want the book, go there, get the book. It's simple, identityshiftbook.com. If you're on Instagram, identityshiftbook.com. I would love somebody to put the URL so I can pin it on my post. And if you're on anything else, which is Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube, Periscope, identityshiftbook.com is on there. But man, I want to make sure you get this message in your life. I want to make sure it's landing on your heart today. It's very straightforward and simple. Do not shoot the messenger. Take it in. Let that be the thing that helps you be better. Because sometimes we don't have all the answers. Sometimes we don't have all the lessons and the things we need, but we know that someone in our life does. They've walked that path. They've run that race. They've crossed that finish line. They're giving you a nugget of what can change your life. So take that in. Let it simmer. Let it settle. Let it be something amazing. That's my message for you guys today. I'm excited. I don't even know why, man. I love life. I'm getting some labs. My wife on my office desk said, go get I got labs and x-rays today. Because she's like, she says, health first. So I'm excited to go and get that done so I can eat food because you have to fast for like 12 hours. So I'm looking forward to eating food. Sakshi says, are you a motivational speaker? Of many things I am. Oh, I appreciate that. We have the Dana Show put the pin up there. Thank you so much, The Dana Show. Thank you, thank you. Yeah, if you guys want, go to identityshiftbook.com. Pre-order a copy of your book right now. It comes out May 18th for the rest of the world. It comes out earlier for you, but that's it. Take care. God bless you, and I'll see you guys.